we have noticed an increase in our community cases as well as our surrounding community cases. And as to be expected, we have more recently noticed an influx in our hospitalized patients. As you would imagine, the common risk factors that we were aware of when the pandemic started continue to be the same risk factors that we're seeing in those individuals who not only contract COVID, but go on to develop a more severe course. The more resurgence of COVID, I'm noticing a lot of a younger population, and that may be just behaviorally related. We started with very common fever and cough and shortness of breath, and the criteria has now expanded. It's almost a page long when you look at it. We are now seeing more, I think, non-specific symptoms, which may include body aches, the fatigue, the loss of taste, the loss of smell. An important message is that we know we are entering flu season. We're still going to see COVID circulating. So really, really important to make sure that you get out there and you do what you can do to prevent influenza, which is get that vaccine. Also really important to continue to practice those risk mitigation strategies with COVID-19, because having kind of those two viruses, competing at the same time does have the potential to inundate hospital systems.